Hi, and welcome back to MyExcelOnline.com. Today's topic is one that I'm pretty sure we all struggle with, and it's reducing too many emails. Is checking your email one of the first things you do in the morning? Is it one of the first things you do when you get to work? Are you feeling like your inbox is out of control, and sometimes you just don't even want to look at it because it's too frightening because you know there's over 1,000 emails in there, and you're never going to get to them all? Did you know that about 30% of the workday, on average, is spent reading emails? That seems like a lot of time. Well, hopefully today's lesson will help encourage you and help you not to feel so intimidated by your inbox.
I have 5 tips for you today
on how to hopefully tame the inbox so that we can at least feel like we're back in control of our communications instead of them being in control of us.
If you want to learn more about Microsoft Excel and Office, join our Academy online course and access more than 1,000 video training tutorials so that you can advance your level and get the promotions, pay raises, or new jobs. The link to join our Academy online course is in the description.
So the first one is thinking about intentional email time instead of responsive email time. And what I mean by those things is not scheduling a time to check your email, but more like having focus time on email. So it's not like at 10 o'clock every day I'm going to check my email, but it's more like this is time I'm putting aside right now only for email, and then I'm planning on moving on to something else. Instead of I'm working on something and, oh, I see my notification, I see that I have an email. I'm going to make some recommendations for getting rid of some of those notifications so that they're not distracting to us and we can focus our time on something else. So basically what I would like to say is setting up a strategy to think about having email time and then having work time and then finishing that task for work time and then coming back to email time. So let's look at some ways we can get rid of some of those email distractions. In Microsoft Outlook, if I go to the File menu and I go down to Options, I can click on Mail. And if I scroll down, I see this Message Arrival section. And this Message Arrival section is what I like to think of as the distraction section. So when new messages arrive, no, don't play a sound. No, don't change the mouse pointer. Don't show an envelope icon in the taskbar, and don't display a desktop alert. Because if I turn all of those off and I'm still having intentional email time throughout my day, unless I'm waiting for something really, really urgent, I don't need to have all of these things on. So I'm going to uncheck all of those and hit OK. So most people leave Microsoft Outlook up during the whole day, but one of the simplest things you can do is hit this little X here and exit out of Microsoft Outlook when you are not having email time. And that way, you're not going to get those notifications because Outlook isn't even running. But a lot of people can't do that because sometimes you do have to go back into your inbox and you do have to get some information for what you're working on. It's not always an option for everyone to shut Outlook down. That's why I showed those other options that can be turned off. Another option you can have in Microsoft Outlook if you want to turn off some of your distractions is go over here to Send Receive and hit this button right here that says Work Offline. This will disconnect you from the server and not have any notifications coming in during the time that you want to still have Outlook up, but you don't want to be distracted by it. So between those different settings that you can set, being able to shut down Outlook and being able to use the Work Offline option, hopefully a lot of those notifications will be taken away. But don't forget, there's also some Windows settings for Microsoft Outlook. So if I go down here to Notifications, I can scroll down here and I can see that there's a lot of notifications for different applications on Windows. And most of these I'm going to turn off, but there is one for Outlook down here. There's banners and sounds. So if you're still getting some notifications after you've turned off all those settings in Outlook, you might want to come back here and check and make sure they're turned off at the Windows level as well. The second tip I have today is how you think about and you process email. Do you remember going to the mailbox and getting tons of letters and going through that stack of mail and thinking about what you're going to do with each piece of mail? Well, email is very, very similar. So what I do when I check my mail is I walk out to the mailbox, and on the way back in the house, I'm already sorting through all of my mail. And in one part of my hand, I'm holding the trash that I'm just going to get rid of. And then I have a second category of things I'm going to keep in file. And then I have a third category of things I'm going to take care of right away. So when I get back in the house, I've kind of already sifted through all of my mail and categorized it in my head. And I dump the trash ones in the trash right away so I never have to look at them again. And then I take the ones that I need to do something with, but not right now, and put them in one pile. And then I take the things that I'm going to do something with right away, whether it's make a phone call or pay a bill. And I take action on those as soon as I can. So I think about email very similarly. When a message comes in, there's a process that happens in my head. And if it's an email that I can take action on right away, it's going to take me about a minute. I'm just going to do it so I don't have to think about it again. And usually that's like send an attachment to someone, answer a quick question. Those are the best kinds of emails because they're in, you delete them, and they're out. But then there's those emails that come in, kind of like this email right here. I click on this one. And I go, I don't really need stuff for my Microsoft account, so I'm just going to delete it. That's like the mail that I have that's throwing it in the trash. Or I click on this email, I hit reply, and then I delete it. That is like the stack of mail that I can take immediate action on. And those, I think most people have that down to a science where they don't have to worry about those emails. You know to delete or you know to respond right away. It's the emails that don't take an immediate action that tend to clog up our inbox, and then we don't always know what to do with those. So on some of those, if you know it's an action and it's something you're going to do, but you know that you're not going to get a chance to do that for maybe a week or so, or if it's a bill that's due, but you're not planning on paying it for another week, or it's like a car inspection or something that can actually be turned into an event. Usually I hit these three dots and I go to meeting. I'm actually creating this email now as an event for me to do in the future. So I can change the start time down here to, let's say, next week at the same time. And if I hit send, I'm not sending this to anyone because I just want it to appear in my calendar. So I'm just going to hit send anyway. And if I go down here to my calendar, I can see that that event has automatically been created on my calendar for me. So if I go back to my inbox, I can just delete the email because when I go back to my calendar, it's still an event on my calendar and I'll just take care of it then. So that is one of my favorite tips, to be able to turn emails into calendar events and then get rid of the email.
If you are liking this video, please give us a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel and hit the bell button to get notified when we release our weekly videos.
So point number three, what about those emails where you know you need to take some kind of action, you don't have a time yet to schedule them for, you can't think of a way to schedule them maybe for next week so you can think about it later, but you know you need to hang on to them? I think those fall into a couple of different categories. One can be things to do and the other one can be things to keep. So what I would recommend in this kind of scenario is creating some kind of folder structure where you can categorize a whole bunch of your emails. But the downside to that is if you create too many folders, you're not going to go back and look at them all because that's going to become an overwhelming problem in and of itself. And a lot of times, if you don't go back and check those folders, it's kind of out of sight, out of mind. That's why I recommended keeping some messages inside of your inbox to guilt you until you do them. But you can't do that with too many of them because then your inbox itself becomes cluttered. So what I recommend is a very simple file structure of folders that you will go back and look at. So right here, I'm going to right click and go to new folder. And I'm going to create a folder called to do. And I'm also going to right click and go to new folder. And I'm going to create a folder called to keep. And you can see down here that there's those two folders now, to do and to keep. So if I look at this and I go, oh, well, this is a message that I need to keep because I know I'm going to need this later on, I'm going to move this into the folder called to keep. And this is a to do item. And I can just click and drag that into a folder called to do. And I have to remember to check my to do list regularly. So if you think you're going to forget that, you can actually make a setting inside of Outlook that takes you directly to your to-do list first before you check anything in your inbox. So let me show you how to do that. So if I go up to File and I go down to Options and I go to Advanced, right here, Outlook Start and Exit, Start Outlook in this folder. If I hit Browse, I can scroll down to my to-do list and hit OK. And then I'm going to hit OK on here. So let's close down Outlook. And when I open it back up, you can see that to-do has been the folder that Outlook has been open to. So I can check what I have in my to-do list every time I open up Microsoft Outlook. And then I can go to my inbox and I can check for new emails. So a lot of this is just about creating habits. We've all already created the habit to open our inbox on a regular basis. But once in our inbox, we should be looking at our to-do list and making sure that we are getting those items done. And if that's not working out, then we probably need to come up with a plan B strategy to look at our immediate items somehow. Maybe you'll just want to keep those in your inbox and not move them to subfolders. So point number four is kind of like the reduce, reuse, recycle. If we would reduce what we're using from the source, then we wouldn't even have to deal with the problem to begin with. So when I look at some of my emails coming in, what does it mean to reduce from the source? So in some of your emails, there is an unsubscribe link when they come in, and you could hit the unsubscribe link and stop subscribing to so many things. Like sometimes you're like, how did I even get on this email list? But if you hit unsubscribe, the next time you get that email, right before you hit delete, then you won't have to keep hitting delete in the future. So unsubscribing is a very good strategy for reducing your inbox. You can also reduce your inbox by creating some rules when they come in if unsubscribing is not working. If you recognize a pattern of certain emails coming in, or you're still getting emails from someone that you don't want to talk to anymore, or you don't need to communicate with anymore, you can create a rule for your inbox. So say this is an email that you don't want to get anymore. You can right click and go to rules and go to create rule. And you have a lot of different options in here. If you're getting a certain subject that you don't care about anymore, you could write that in here and do something with those kinds of messages right when they come in. You could also go to advanced options with specific words in the recipient's address. And if I hit that rule, I can say, I don't want anything more from Microsoft. I wouldn't do that because I do want Microsoft's emails. But if I were to add that here and say, okay, I can hit next. And these are the different actions I can take on those kinds of emails. I can delete it, or I can permanently delete it so that I don't even see it in my trash. So I won't even know that I got that email. And you can see that Outlook gives me a warning about that too. Am I sure I want no record of even getting that email? If I say yes, then I can permanently delete it. But you may not want to check that off. You might want it just to go to your trash. And then I can hit next. And you can even put some exceptions on here. Are there any exceptions? You know, what if it's coming from CEO@Microsoft.com? Then I probably want to keep that checked. So you can create some exceptions to your rule, and you can just come up with a name for the rule. And I will just put Microsoft delete and hit finish. And this warning is just telling me that this rule is only going to apply to Outlook, and it's not going to apply to every email system that I have out there on other applications. And that's fine. I can just say okay. And then if I ever need to see that rule again, I can right click and go to rules and go to manage rules and alerts. And I can see that rule on there, and I can delete that rule if I no longer want Microsoft emails going right to my trash when it comes in. So rules can be really, really helpful to sort your emails and to do something with them automatically. There's also something called a quick step. And if I go to the home ribbon and go down here, I can create a new quick step where I can just move something to a folder. And let's say I want this to move to my to-do folder, and I hit finish. So now instead of clicking this and dragging it down here to my to-do folder, I can just click on the to-do, and it will move that email for me automatically to my to-do folder down here. And that's what has happened. So my fifth tip is I've created all of these folders over here. During one of my focus times on email, it would be good for me to go through each one of these folders and decide if I still want to hang on to those messages or not. And that's going to be a really timely process. So maybe set aside time each month to go through what you have in your subfolders to make sure that you don't have too much information in there, because you can create the same problem with your inbox that you can create with one of your subfolders. You can just have too many messages in there that you don't even want to look at it anymore. So that is kind of a focus time that you would have to go through each of your subfolders and decide whether or not you still want to hang on to things. Maybe you have a subfolder called coupons, and half those coupons have expired. Just delete them and get rid of them. So those are the five tips that I have for how to hopefully start taming your inbox. If you have any good tips, please leave them below and share them with other people listening to this video, because all of us can learn from each other on what we can do to help tame this inbox monster. Hope you learned something new today. Look forward to seeing you again next time. If you want to learn more about Microsoft Excel and Office, join our Academy online course and access more than 1,000 video training tutorials so that you can advance your level and get the promotions, pay raises, or new jobs. The link to join our Academy online course is in the description.
If you like this video, subscribe to our YouTube channel. And if you're really serious about advancing your Microsoft Excel skills so you can stand out from the crowd and get the jobs promotions and pay rises that you deserve, then click up here and join our Academy online course today.